mentioned that this is made about 3 hours late from the 1 o'clock continuance of our April 18th meeting. Two of our elders have been asking about the grasshopper program. We had to get it done. We got to get grasshoppers. Our people voted for it to do the program. Does somebody entertain a motion to activate the grasshopper program? Moved by John Bell Silva, seconded by our lady vice chair. All those in favor of this action, please signify by saying aye. Aye. All those opposed, same sign. A historic day happened today. I want the Comanche Nation to know what your elected leaders do. We have three veterans. We have two ceremonial people from the ceremonial family. I have the great-great-granddaughter of the late Paula Parker. This just didn't happen overnight. We have been in mediation, a lot of controversies, and we tried and things like that. And we believe that we believe all the compacts should honor the men. One thing we did find out, we can't have a negative and a negative of men. And let's go out on all of our social media outlets. This is exactly what was fun for the Comanche Nation today. What was fun was for the youth of the Comanche Nation. The only reason I ran for office was for this day. And I've got to thank God that He allowed CBC 1, CBC 2, CBC 3, CBC 4, our Secretary Treasurer, our Vice Chair, to lead us to this point. If I was going to all the particulars tonight, I would take all day long. There will be other tribes that go after your independent, Lords of the Plains, Comanche Nation, and they will follow any tribe. We never conceded to any tribe. We are a government. We are a government within a government. And this is what I read to the governor today, the state of Oklahoma. The Comanche Nation, the state of Oklahoma, the Constitution of the United States gives authority of American Indian Affairs to the federal government, not to the state government. Just as the United States deals with states as governments, it also deals with American Indian tribes, nations, and townships as governments. Today is a government-to-government agreement. For the record, the Comanche Nation has had its own inherent place in the United States since time immemorial. Original lands that the Comanche Nation calls home is Texas, Oklahoma, and throughout the Great Plains. The Comanche Nation is not a special interest group. We're not just individuals or some other type of non-governmental entity. The Lords of the Plains is who we are and will forever continue to be. The Comanche Nation stands as a sovereign government within the United States. The Comanche Nation has its own constitution, adopted in 1967. The Comanche Nation has its own tax commission, its own court, its own law enforcement, its own elections. The Comanche Nation looks upon treaties, the actual treaties of land affairs, with the United States of America as law. Of their presence today and for the future of this people. We are a sovereign nation within this nation. The supreme power of this Comanche Nation is measured by its enrolled members who are 18 years or older that are aptly named the Tribal Council. The spirits of the Tribal Council are the elected Senate Business Committee members that comprise the Chairman, Vice Chair, Secretary Treasurer, and 4 committee members. The legal quorum of 5 business committee members have the stewards in power to enact governing legislation, negotiation, and signature agreements. The legal forum for the Commission Nation Business Committee on Saturday, April 18, 2020, did move to accept gaming compact with the state of Oklahoma and the Commission Nation. Resolution number 56-2020 was called for and passed a legal form. Chairman William Nelson Sr., Vice Chair Lenora Parker, Secretary Treasurer Robert Tippett, Committee Member Number 1, Jay Sova, Committee Member Number 2, Diane Miguel Doria Bysova, Committee Member Number 3, Ronald Redo, and Committee Member Number 4, Clyde Narco. Our legal monthly meeting is continued for today, April 21st, 2020, as approved by a motion of action on Saturday, April 18th, 2020. I read this at the Capitol, and I said this at the Capitol. We are here at the State Capitol of Oklahoma to finalize our business with the state of Oklahoma. And I looked at Governor Smith, I said, Governor Smith, Comanche Nation Business Committee, Mr. Jim Sobo, I'd like to share with you this day a ceremonial of our people that will finalize our agreement between two governments. May God, share his grace of peace and discernment over our ancient ways of truth and goodness. The ceremony that Jim performed, I'll let him tell the audience what it was he did not see. In 1996, Washington, D.C., all of us in the House of Authority across the nation was one of the men along the front. Officer, you are of budget in Washington, D.C., so how would you do well a little bit to build the building? And with that, the Native Americans should know, we don't have a handle on how to do it in Washington. Well, they put out a law, and they said, you can take this across the land, carry the crop, come back with something that's going to work for everybody. Well, back then they figured, you can't get a handful of people, Native Americans, together and not come up with something that's going to work for them. They couldn't be done. Well, we done it. We had about 15, 20 minutes across the United States. All our representatives and our House members and our law people came together to divide that law into about 12, 15 different pieces. And each one took the piece in hand. It all worked through all these meetings. They come back with a law that was going to satisfy everybody. Took the Washington, D.C., and when they presented it to the Congress and the Native Americans, when they signed it, as the people from the United States signed it, the Congress, they signed it. When our Native American representatives signed it, they struck that it was blessed. At the same time, the ceremony we done there that we played for everybody, we done it down here today. We share that same time that we did one of the ceremonies, a little ceremony, so we go to the start of a prayer, finish through a prayer. Went along the way with these birds and men to run over all of why. But all these little people, those here. And what better to the Cherokees to hold it in high regard like we do the Golden Eagle? So we use the two because he was each Cherokee. And put them together and we said, these two birds are still the sky together as they watch over all our people. When we do this out here together, told the government, all the Oklahoma people he represented, we're going to walk together down that road of life here on our Mother Earth and share with you all the apostles. That's the word that does. And at the end, we prayed. We said a prayer for our frontline people that fight this violence that's trying to take over God's creation. From the seas to the west, from the seas to the east, it's trying to take over everything. We pray we can take it away. We don't go our feet with that devil guy. And we need to choose to pray like that. And when we finish, we presented that light. Bald eagle feather to the other skin. We got to just kill them. We presented the double eagle to our father on behalf of our this bird's not here. That's what they say. They love everybody. They say the same thing. They love one another like that. We finished up with a prayer. And that's what we're doing. Forgive. Forgive. Thank you.